Hi friends, welcome to the channel of Learning by Doing. And today I'm going to talk about some more HTML tags. And today, first of all, I'm going to start with division tag. So I'm going to start with division tag. We'll put our title as division tag. Okay, guys, and coming to the body part, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about the division tag. What is division tag and what is the use of division tag in the HTML is nothing but you can write a part of your text, like a division of your text. If you are writing over all the paragraph in the blue color, in the black color, and you want to highlight your text in the middle with the blue color or in the different font or anything that whatever you want, but that will gonna happen and using this division tag. I'm going to show you. The division tag was going to be in the form of div within the angular braces, and within the division tag I'm going to write today we are talking about the division. Okay, guys, and we'll discuss some more tags also. I wrote this within the division tag, but I want this text to be highlighted compared to the other part of the web area. I'm going to write in the body part a paragraph. Hi friends, welcome to the second class of HTML5. Okay, and this is within the paragraph, and I put one division tag here. I'll end the paragraph here after the division tag. Within the paragraph, I'm going to put this division tag. Then how it's going to be work, we'll see. And I want this text to be highlighted with some style, right? So I want, there is another attribute in the HTML file that is nothing but a style attribute. The style attribute. For this style attribute, I'm going to give this is called the element also, and for this element I'm going to give another attribute called the color to my text here within the division tag. Okay, I'm going to give the color here. Let me give color as blue, no, red. Red. Okay, I put the red color for my text, which is in between the paragraph tag. We inserted another tag called the division tag, and in this division tag I'm highlighted some of the text, and I want that text to be in red color for my web page. So I'm gonna save this. It is already saved. Okay, I'm gonna run it. See, guys, see here. I'll just zoom the page. See, in the paragraph tag, I wrote, "Hi friends, welcome to the second class of HTML5," and also all this blah 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 thing. But in the paragraph tag, I inserted another tag called the division tag, which is going to divide this text from that part of paragraph that's going to be in a highlighted text or an underlined text of that paragraph. That content. This is the use of the division tag, and I'm going to tell you another tag called, we'll discuss about the insert tag now. Insert tag, within this I'm going to keep one insert. insert tag. See guys, here I'm going to insert one more tag called an insert tag. What is the use of this insert tag? We'll see it. Insert tag can be written in the form of ins. It as usual ends with an slash ins. Insert tag, the main use of this insert tag is it's going to give underline to your text that was which shows that important this text is going to be more important. Okay guys, so this is one of the tag, a simple tag, that's it. And I'm going to show you another tag here itself. That is a simple tag which I forget to say yesterday. That was the subscripted tags and the superscripted tags. I will show you the subscripted tag now. The subscripted tag will be shown, will be written as sub within the angular braces, and it will be ends with slash sub. And the superscripted tag will be written as sub. The starting letters of the superscription, that's it. There is no any specific thinking of what tag it will be and all this. From the subscription and the superscription tags, we'll come to know that the subscription, whatever we wrote between the subscription tags, will be comes with a low font but downside, I mean like enter, and the superscription will be on top. I mean like whenever you wrote 2 square, 3 square, the square will be on upper side, right? For that, we'll need this subscriptions and the superscription tags. These are all very simple tags. We doesn't need any extra explanations for this. And I'm going to show you another very, very important tag called the address tag. Address tag. Address tag. What is meant by the address tag? Everyone knows that we are having some of the address to our home, and we are having some of the address to our offices. And how we're going to represent in the address tag, we'll see here. There is nothing difference. There is just like a text area here itself. But what the main important thing of the address tag is, in the address tag we can't insert the some of the tags within it. It doesn't accept some of the tags within it, like any frame sets and all, some of the style tags. It doesn't accept all those things. It accepts only the link reference tags or any text part. I mean, if you write any text as usual, it will accept it. And if you write any link, I mean, I didn't said about the link, that is anchor tag and all this. If you want to give any address to something, it will accept those. But it doesn't accept any other type of tags within it. That was the main importance of this address tag. And I'm going to give a small text within this because I didn't said about the anchor tag and all this. After that, we'll see how to put the anchor tag within the address tag. Okay. Okay, I wrote that list.
It accepts the text, that's it. And it accepts the anchor tags. But it doesn't accept any extra kind of different kinds of tags, like paragraph within the address tag and all this. Okay, guys? I'm going to use some break because... Sorry.
Okay. Let me see how it's going to look now. I'm going to save this. And we'll see in the Chrome. See guys, here I have used the subscripted tag for and so it came below this, and I have used the superscripted tag for the discuss so it came above this, and in the address tag I have written this text part, so in the format it came as usual as Ram Kochi Chennai. And this is all about the new tag that we are going to be learning today. And here we have we are seeing here an underline to this area. This is, I already inserted one of the tag there.
That is nothing but the inserted tag. For that inserted tag, there is no any specific explanation. It just highlights your text by giving an underline. That is an underline marked text. That's it. And now I'm going to show you some more tags.
A very beautiful tag which I really don't know so many times, but I came to know after a long time. That is the BDO tag. BDO tag is nothing but the text will be displayed from right to left direction. Right to left direction. I mean, some text will be written. It is depends upon the direction. In whatever the direction are you going to be, want your font to be, then it will come as right to left or left to right, however you want it. So I want my text to be in right to left direction, so I'm giving RTL here, and I got a doubt at the time that why they inserted this tag. I don't know at that moment when I'm learning this HTML. So I came to know that many of the languages, like Arab countries languages and all this, they wrote their language from right to left direction. And some of the languages like Urdu and all these also, they wrote their language from right to left direction. So for that purpose they inserted this BDO tag, which gonna show your text from right to left direction. Okay, and I'm going to tell you another type of tag called the KBD tag. It is nothing but it's a common tag which gonna give some text style which is different text style. That's it, which is a new feature in this HTML file. I'm going to write just a comment right to left in this, and I'm going to put KDB in this. KDB is nothing but which is going to give some different kinds of text style for your format. Now we are going to learn a very important tag called the VAT tag. Why it is more important is sometimes we are giving formulas to our web page. I mean, sometimes we are giving the formula like a plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab, and what the HTML will understand, a as in a text character, b as in a character, and 2 as a number, as like this. But here in this formula, a is also a mathematical element and b is also a mathematical element, and how that going to be understood by this HTML language is that is going to be happen by using the var character.
Var tag. So within this var tag, we need whatever we think that as in a mathematical element, like a is in a mathematical element here and b is also a mathematical element. So in that case, we need to write in between the var tags. Like
this is the var tag, as usual, the starting tag and the ending tag. I wanna show that the simple a plus b whole square formula. A plus B whole, and I already said to you for the superscription, we need to use that superscription tag, right? SUP for 2, A plus B whole square, we are going to write it here, and the is equal to is also a mathematical element. And here I'm gonna show you one more thing, that if this square, this is all to be in one part, right? So we will put this slash var, this is going to be all, this is a mathematical element, and we'll put the is equal to here, and we know that we'll copy this. I don't wanna write again and again. I'll put it here, and I'll put it again, I'll put it again, I'll put it again. Okay. Okay, See, here I know a plus b whole square is equal to a square. A is in a mathematical element, and b is also in a mathematical element. B square plus 2ab. 2ab is also in a mathematical element. So, in between this, we are going to write the this is slash n tags of bar tag, and this is also the n tag of bar tag. And here I'm going to write the superscription tag because that is an a square plus b square, right? I'm going to copy this. I'm going to paste this here, and after b square will be there, right? And in between this, we're going to write insert or general mathematical plus minus symbols and all this. A square plus b square plus 2ab. This is the main var character. I mean, the var tag is going to show you the elements which we wrote in between the var tags or the mathematical elements. They are not the general characters. I mean, not general ABCDs. Okay, guys, did you got what I'm going to say you? Are you clear, right? And I'm going to show you how it's going to look. And wait for some time because I'm going to put some break here. Because that may not look confusing to you. I'm gonna save this. We'll see it here. See what I wrote there, right to left direction in the BDO. In the BDO tag, we wrote the direction as right to left, so it came as right to left in this direction. And we are using the KDB. This is one of the just a style formatting tag. And here we got a formula. We got the formula, right? A plus b whole square is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab, because we wrote, and here the web page is also considers a, b, and all these as the mathematical elements. Okay, guys. And thanks for watching this video, and we'll learn about the more and more tags in our next class. Thanks for watching.